Hi, kindergarten friends. How are you?
You did it. You made it to Friday. Today is Friday, March 5th.
Woohoo! You did it!
I hope you had an okay week. Let's go ahead and check in with your zone and how you're feeling today. Are you feeling bored or sad or frustrated or really excited about something? Or are you feeling mad or angry? What's your feeling today? How am I feeling today?
How are you feeling, Mrs. Wally?
Well, I'm in the green zone. I'm really glad it's Friday. I'm really excited to spend time with Oliver this weekend and Mr. Wally. And we get to go do something fun this weekend.
What?
Well, Mr. Wally's brother, his wife had a baby in January, and we haven't been able to meet him yet, and we get to go meet him this weekend. And I'm really excited. I still will have to wear my mask and stay 6 feet away to keep the baby safe, but I get to see him in person instead of on the screen, and I am so excited.
Wow.
And Oliver will get to meet his new cousin. And it's his only boy cousin. All his other cousins are girls. And so it's exciting, and all his other cousins are much older. The youngest of all his other cousins is in second grade. She's in first grade, first or second grade. So, and Oliver's only two. So they're much different in age. So
they'll be friends.
They will be friends. And his name's Owen. So it's Oliver and Owen.
Oh, O&O.
O&O. All right, friends. Mr. Kevin, how are you today?
I'm in a pretty good space today. Pretty good mood.
I'm so glad. Oh, there he is. Hi, Mr. Kevin.
Hi,
I'm glad you're doing well today. That's so good. Do you have anything fun you're looking forward to this weekend?
Nope. Gonna do the usual stuff around the house.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Make sure to get everything in order.
Yeah. Which, sometimes adults really love to do chores.
We do. Sometimes it really helps you feel in the green zone, actually.
Mm-hmm.
I know friends at home must be thinking we're crazy, but sometimes getting things organized and in order for the next week can really help your brain feel like you're in the green zone.
You're right.
It's true. All right. Let's get going with Number Fun Friday.
All right.
Now, we've been practicing adding. What would this make, kindergartners? If I have three, and then I get two more, what would it make? You might just draw it on your whiteboard, and that's fine. If you said five, ding, 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 that is correct. Ooh, now if three and two is five, what would happen if I changed this to a three? Wonder what we would get. Three is just one more than two. So what's three and three? I heard someone say, it's a double, you're right. Both addends are the same. These are things you want to memorize. Three plus three is six. Awesome. What's four plus four? It's another double. If three plus three is six, and I make this four instead of three, and this four instead of three, both of them have just gone up by one. We had three, and we're just adding one more. And we had three, and we're just adding one more. We knew three and three was six, and two more is eight. Ooh. Now we have the four. Instead of four and four, we have four and three, just one less. What's one less than eight? Seven. We can check it. Four, five, six, seven. Yep, we got it. What's four and two more, friends? Four plus two. Four and two. There's that silly line again. Four and two is six. Excellent. Today, we're learning to find the parts to a whole. So far, we've been taking two parts, putting them together, and telling what the whole is. Today, we're gonna build the whole and figure out a way we can split it and make two parts. Well, that's gonna be fun. Take a look, what do you see? How many shapes do you see, Mr. Kevin?
I see two different kinds of shapes.
But how many shapes altogether?
Five.
Five. What's a story we could tell about this, Mr. Kevin?
Well, let's see. We've got, you know, there's a couple of ways we could go, right?
Yeah, pick one. Okay. And then I'll do the other one.
So we've got a square.
One square.
One square plus four circles.
One square plus four circles. We took five and we put it into two parts. We did one square and four circles for a total of five. Here's another way, friends. I wonder if anyone saw this way. Two red shapes and three blue shapes.
Mm-hmm.
And I have five shapes. All right. Okay, Mr. Kevin, if I could get my white, actually, no, I'm gonna do it here, friends. What I want you to do at home, I want you to have your counters out. And when I tell you the number, I want you to put that many out. So if I say four, I want you to put out four counters. And I'm gonna do one, two, three, four. Now, it has a red question mark and a yellow question mark. So how many do I want to be red and how many do I want to be yellow? I'm gonna show you, are you ready? How could we split this up? Mr. Kevin, how do you think we should split it up? How many reds should we have?
Well, on that first one, we get to choose.
We get to choose.
Oh, okay.
Isn't that fun? We're gonna take the whole of four and split it into the parts.
Okay,
we get to pick the parts now.
I'm gonna be funny. I'm gonna say one red.
Okay. One red.
And three yellow.
Three yellow. So if I take four, I can split it into parts of one and three. Because one and three together make four. Mm-hmm. Okay, my next number, my next total is five. See right here, it says five. So I'm gonna make five circles. Two, three, four, five. You take your counters and you decide how many are gonna be red and how many are gonna be yellow. Now your counters might not be red and yellow, but you can pretend. Mabel, what do you think? Mabel says, two reds. Pebble, if we have two reds, how many yellows will we have if we have five? Three, there's three left. Three yellow. Five equals two plus three. Okay. Oh, look, we get to do five again. How many reds this time, friends? Ooh, someone said four reds. Okay, one, two, three, four reds. How many yellows should we do? One yellow. Five equals four plus one. Awesome.
Four reds and one yellow sounds like my commute in the morning. Yeah.
Is that what the light colors do when you're driving,
yeah,
Mr. Kevin?
Turn
you know,
red,
lately
turn
I've
red.
Been on Yakima Street coming down to the district office. I've been getting green, 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 red, and then I turn.
Wow.
I must have it timed perfectly.
You must?
Yep, it's pretty great. I think it's really, and I can watch the lights changing as I'm driving. It's pretty cool. Okay, friends. Uh-oh, it's not five anymore, but we have a five frame. What are we gonna do? It says we need to have three. Well, but this is a five frame. Am I gonna fill in the whole five frame? Why not, Mr. Kevin?
Because if you filled it all the way in, it would mean that you had five of something.
Oh, I wonder if we just cross off the ones that we're not gonna use.
Oh, that's a good idea.
And then we can just fill in the ones we are gonna use.
Mm-hmm.
So friends, let's see. How many reds do you wanna do? Two. Two reds. And how many yellows? One yellow. Two plus one equals three. Or we could have done one red and two yellows and be one plus two equals three. I'm gonna see if you can figure out this next one that I'm gonna do. Are you ready? It's four, so I need to cross off one because we're not going to use all of them. How many reds did I use? Zero. How many yellows did I use? Four.
Tricky.
Zero
Mrs.
plus four
Wally.
Equals four. That was tricky, wasn't it?
Tricky.
Tricky, tricky. Oh, look, we're going to use five. Do we need to cross any boxes off? Mm-mm. Nope. We're going to use all five. Okay. I'm going to do this. And then this. What parts did I split five into? One red, four yellow. Woohoo! Nice job, friends. You took the whole and split them into the two parts and told what the parts in the whole made and checked your work. Okay. Mr. Kevin, can you show my whiteboard? Now we have a story problem. Are you ready, kindergartners? I think you're ready. There are four butterflies. One more joins them. How many butterflies are there now? What's happening here? Yeah, we've got butterflies and they're flying and some come. Okay, what are we trying to figure out? What's the question that we're answering? I'm gonna read again and I want you to listen for the question. It's when I'm asking something. There are four butterflies. One more joins. How many butterflies are there now? What's the question? How many butterflies are there now? What information do we know? Let's read it again. There are four butterflies and one more joins them. Oh, there are four butterflies. There are four butterflies. And one more joins them. How many butterflies are there now? We made an equation with these counters. There's four plus one equals something. Look, that's the equation they got. What is four and one more, friends? It's five. There are five butterflies now. Your assignment today is to do page 348 in your math workbook, where you're figuring out what the total is and then splitting it into reds and yellows, just like we did today. Today we learned to find the parts of a whole. We modeled the whole, we determined ways to break up the whole into two parts, and then we wrote the parts in an addition equation. Mr. Kevin, if they want to contact us here at the TV classroom, how can they do that?
Friends, all you have to do is ask your adult to help you, send us an email to tvclassroom at tacoma.k12.wa.us. Or you can send it in the mail to TV Classroom, 601 South 8th Street, Tacoma, Washington, 98405.
All right, friends. Excellent job today. I hope that you have a wonderful weekend. Up next is going to be your break and then your time with Miss Oslin. Make sure that you gather your materials and you're ready to learn when she comes on. You'll need your ELA packet, your learning notebook, your pencil, and your learning buddy. All right, friends, I hope you have a great weekend and I will see you next time. Bye.
Rules. 1. You have 10 seconds to pick your crewmate. 2. A new timer will appear with an exercise for the crewmate you picked. 3. You will get 10 points for each correct crewmate and exercise you choose. 4. If you pick the imposter, you will lose all your points. 5. See how many points you can get. Good luck.
Hi, kindergartners. Welcome back from your break. Excellent job gathering your materials and being ready to learn. For now, you don't need your pencil and your learning notebook or your crayons. You can set those to the side, but go ahead and keep your learning buddy with you if they're going to help you focus today. Okay, let's remind ourselves today and every day when we come together, your job is to say this with me, listen,
share,
read, and write. Excellent job.
Correct.
Now, listening, active listening looks like and sounds like your, say this out loud, eyes watching, ears listening, voice quiet, and if it helps you, your body is still.
Body still.
But
I didn't do it. I'm sorry.
You didn't say it with me, Mr. Kevin.
I didn't say it with you.
How do I know that you're going to show active listening?
Okay, I'm going to do it real quick.
Okay.
Eyes listening. Eyes watching, ears listening, voice quiet, body still.
But sometimes, Mr. Kevin, even though you're showing active listening, does your mind start to think about other things?
It does.
Mine too.
Yeah. So we have to remind ourselves to focus.
And we say it really nicely because it happens to everyone.
Yeah.
Right? Focus. Okay, when you live the life of a writer, like you and I do, you're able to spot ideas all around you, just like Pam Munoz Ryan did when she wrote Hello Ocean, right? There is no shortage of ideas when you know that there are so many possibilities of things that you can write about. We've been discussing some really amazing authors and where they get their ideas from. And we can use that, we call that a mentor text, which means it teaches us how to be writers. So Hello Ocean is a mentor text. It teaches us how to notice what is around us and use that in our writing. We also read Dreamweaver by Jonathan London. You'll remember Jonathan London got the idea for Dreamweaver when he went on a hike with his kids, right? And he practiced walking quietly through the forest and spotting a spider and then spinning a tale all about this spider. Or we read The Chalk Doll by Charlotte Pomerantz and pictures by Frenée Lissac. And this was all about special things that our characters had, keepsakes or mementos. And they wrote many, many stories about those keepsakes and mementos. And you and I also thought about what keepsakes and mementos we have that we could write about. Today, we're going to think about how writers consider the purpose, audience, and commitment to their ideas when they're deciding what to publish. That means we need to think about why we're writing, we need to think about who is going to be reading it, and we need to think about, is this something we really want to keep writing about? Now, if we had a keepsake, like I remember, I started writing about the keepsake that was the clock that's on my mantle. Now, I bet I could come up with a really neat story about the clock, that would be interesting to read and that you would might want to read, but my commitment as a writer, I'm not really interested in writing about the clock. So that would not be a good idea for me to write about. Let's look at some more of our mentor texts while we do this thinking. What do we know about this book, Roller Coaster by Marla Frazee? Take a minute and think about what do we know about this book? Turn and tell your learning buddy what you know about the book Roller Coaster. Mabel, we know this is a book about a little girl's first time riding a roller coaster and how she had a lot of different feelings about it. We also know that the author, Marla Frazee, lives with a bunch of people who really like roller coasters and who helped write this book. She also did some research, which means she had to spend some time on roller coasters to learn more about them. And we can make a good guess as to why she chose to publish this book. Now, today as writers, you and I are gonna think about our different topics. And we're gonna decide which of our ideas we're gonna add more to, we're gonna edit, which means we're gonna fix our spelling, and we're gonna add details to our picture, and we're gonna publish it, which means we're gonna make it really, really strong piece of writing, and be brave, and let someone else read it. Now, let's see. Personal narrative, deciding what to publish. These are things that writers think about when they're deciding which of their idea they're going to keep writing about. We need to make sure that it's a story that we remember really well. So I bet Marla Frazee remembered about her roller coasters really well. This is something that I love to do. We definitely learned that her family loves roller coasters. Maybe it's something that you just can't stop thinking about. That would be a good reason to write about something. Maybe it's something you talk a lot about to your friends or your family. Maybe you think it's a story that your readers will really connect with and enjoy. That's when we consider who our audience is. Is this a topic that people want to read about? Is this idea personal? Is it a story that only you could tell? Well, then you would definitely want to choose that because we would all want to hear a story that you can tell. Is it a story that you want to remember for a long time? Then writing it down would certainly be a great idea. And then, I think this is a story that will make my readers feel good when they read it. Those are all things that we're gonna think about when we decide what to publish. Let's look at another one of our books. I Know a Lady by Charlotte Zolotow, pictures by James Stevenson. Let's see, let's think about, do you remember what this book was about? Take some think time. And tell your learning buddy everything you remember about I Know a Lady. Mabel, I remember that this book is about a special lady who does really nice things. Like I remember she made cookies, she delivered flowers, and it's also about a little girl who's telling the story about the lady because she was so nice to everyone. Now, we know that our author, Charlotte Zolotow, has said that a lady who lived on her block when she was a little girl was her inspiration for writing this book. So why do you think Charlotte chose to publish this book? Well, it must have been a story that was really special to her. We call that being close to your heart. Maybe she wrote it because it was something that she wanted to remember. She wanted to remember all the nice things that her neighbor on her block did for her and other people. Let's see. Something that she knew really well. Maybe she liked to talk about this lady with her friends and family. It's personal, definitely personal. Something that she wants to remember for a really long time. And it's definitely a story that makes readers feel good when they read it. Okay, so now I'm gonna model thinking about all the topics that I've been generating, coming up with ideas for what I can write about for my personal narrative. And I'm gonna model picking one that I want to publish. And I'm gonna start writing about it in my learning notebook. Now, know that this is not my final draft. This is, in fact, my first draft. It's my first time writing about this topic. So it's not going to be perfect. That's when we take it through the writing process and we're gonna go back and revise, add to it to make it better. We're gonna edit it, make sure our spelling is right, make sure we have the right capital letters, make sure we have punctuation. So I was thinking about the keepsake that I had, and I decided that the clock, it's not really a story I know very well. I don't know much about it. It's not something that I love to do. I don't think about it that often. I just don't feel really passionately about the clock on my mantle, so I'm not gonna write about it. What else? Oh, we talked about thinking, really finalizing or getting really focused on our topic. And do you remember I created a graphic organizer about school? So let's think about that. When I think about school, I think about my teacher, I think about playing with my friends, I think about reading books, I think about eating lunch. Let's see, is this something I remember really well? Yeah, I have a lot of details. Definitely something I loved to do. I loved going to school. In fact, when I was in fourth grade, my mom had my brother and I got to be at the hospital with her and I was up all night with her while she was having my brother. And I was really tired the next morning, obviously, because I was up all night. But I still went to school because I loved it so much. I definitely like to tell stories about when I was in school. You know a lot about school. If I write a book about school or a story about school, you would definitely connect to it and probably enjoy it. It's definitely personal because it's my idea about school. And it's a story that I do want to remember for a long time. I'm thinking now about how I could write about school this year because it's so different. That's what I'm gonna do. All right, I have my learning notebook. I'm gonna do some thinking about what is so different about school this year. Well, some of it is in person with your teacher, and some of it was just on your computer. No one has ever had school quite like that. For me, school was different this year because I'm teaching on TV. I don't have any kids in front of me. I have you, but I can't see you. I can't hear you. That is different. I definitely have to tell this story. So here's my picture of my TV classroom. I'm gonna start with, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do like this. This is called a tripod and it's gonna have a camera on it. Doesn't quite look like this.
Not bad.
It's not bad. Friends, do you know who this is? Who's behind the camera? Mr. Kevin. So I definitely have to label this. Mr. Kevin. Ooh, let's clap the syllables in Kevin. Kevin. Okay. In is a snap word. I know it. In Kevin. Okay, Mr. Kevin. And then we have, you know what? Back here in TV classroom is a table. And there's a chair. And sitting in that chair with a computer, keyboard. Oops, that's not a great keyboard, but I can always go back. I will go back and edit and revise and make it better. This is Mrs. Wally. She's working, and then here's our table. Let's see, I'll put me behind the table. And what's my hair doing today? It's down. And I'm smiling. Ooh, I'm not wearing glasses today. Got my hands here. And then who do I need to be sure to include in our TV classroom? These guys. We'll start with Mabel. Okay, Mabel always sits up here. So here's me, that's a snap word. Mabel. Mabel. We know that's M, that's the first letter we learned, isn't it? Mabel. Okay, let's see. That's our table. Wow, okay. Now I need to add some words, let's think. What makes this so special? It's on TV. That is so special and unique. It's definitely, this part of the story is definitely one only Mr. Kevin or Mrs. Wally or I could tell, because not many other people are teaching like this. So I'm gonna write, I'm gonna twist it a little bit so it works. I'm gonna write the year 2020 to 21. I taught school on TV. What else do I want to say? Maybe I should include how I felt about it. How did I feel? I have my feelings word chart here. It was funny, I have felt a lot of different emotions as I've done this. I definitely have been excited, I've definitely been nervous, I've definitely been happy or proud. Sometimes when there were some changes made, it made me a little angry, or I was confused, shocked or surprised. There were times when I was sad or upset, or maybe I made a mistake and I was embarrassed. Definitely was interested. This one is brave. Definitely feeling brave. So I'm gonna say, I felt brave, but it was also really fun. Definitely need to include that. It was, I'm gonna stretch that out. It was fun. Okay. Now I have my first draft. Today we learned that writers have to think about why you're writing something. You have to think about who is gonna read it. And you have to think about, is it something that you really want to write about, that you're interested in writing? And today your job is to go back through all of your graphic organizers, your web, you need to think about your memorable moments that you wrote about, and choose one that you are gonna take through the writing process. Today you're gonna start with your draft, just like I did. You're gonna do your best to draw your picture, get some words on paper. We will go back and change it and edit it, revise it, make it better and beautiful. You're also going to practice your independent reading. And when you do that, I want you to think about why your author may have chosen the ideas that they did to write your independent reading texts. We would love to see your drafts sent here to us at TV Classroom. So get an adult to help you, and Mr. Kevin's gonna tell you how you can send us your writing.
Just email tvclassroom@tacoma.k12.wa.us. You can always mail us too in the regular mail to TV Classroom, 601 South 8th Street, Tacoma, Washington, 98405.
Thank you, Mr. Kevin. Now, kindergartners, it's time for our affirmation. This is when we get to say positive things about ourselves before we go off to do our independent work. And today, your affirmation is, my story is great. Practice saying that out loud with me. My story is great. Excellent job today, kindergartners. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I look forward to seeing you back here next time in our TV classroom. Bye.
Hey kids, we want to see your work. Just send your pictures and your stories to TV Classroom, 601 South 8th Street, Tacoma, Washington, 98405.